You can come into whatever seated position is comfortable for you. Rest your hands on top of your knees, maybe placing the palms to face up so that you soften the wrists. But if you feel like you need to be more grounded today, you can always just place your palms down instead. Close the eyes. And bring your attention to your body. Noticing where parts of your body are touching the mat or the floor. Noticing parts of the body that touch other parts of the body. Noticing the sensation of your clothing pressed against your skin. Checking in into your overall well-being or feeling today. Maybe some of you still feel tired. Maybe some of you feel energetic. Maybe some of you still feel sleepy. So just notice and observe. Noticing if there are certain places in your body that feel tight today. Just observe, maybe doing it in a systematic way, standing from the top of the head, working your way down until you get to the soles of your feet. That way you notice part by part any sensations, any tightness, any soreness, any other feelings or sensations here. And try to keep that same awareness of your body throughout the practice we'll be doing. Noticing whenever your body starts to tell you to stop, to modify, to take a rest. So feel free to come into a resting pose at any point, your child's pose, seiza, shavasana, any resting pose. And feel free to just join back in whenever you're ready to do so. And we'll take one more breath here. And inhale, open your eyes. And from here, coming into your tabletop position or all fours, shoulders on top of the wrists, hips on top of the knees, toes pointing back. Neutral spine here. Suck the belly in, push the mat with the hands so you feel your upper back slightly rounding. And you'll warm up your spine with cat cow. On your next inhale, look up, melt the belly to the floor, lift the tailbone up. And exhale, tuck your chin close to your chest, start to push the mat away from you, lift the back up to the sky and raise to your belly. Inhale, arch your back again, broaden the collarbones, gaze up. And exhale, round the spine in, chin to chest, and look to your belly. Inhale, arch the back again, look up, tailbone up. And exhale, round the spine, look to the belly button. One last time, inhale, arch the back, gaze up. And exhale, round the spine, look to your belly. Inhale, coming back to a neutral spine position. And you can tuck your left toes under for support, or if you want to challenge yourself, keep your left toes pointing back. Then lift your right leg up, flex the right foot, So your right toes pointing down, right leg parallel to the floor. Then bend the right knee so that the right foot facing the ceiling. Now we're going to do this 5 times, just little pulses as you exhale. Lift the right foot up to the sky, inhale, come back down. Exhale, up, down, 2 more, up, and down, hold. Straighten the right leg, and then right knee comes back down to your tabletop. Now let's do the other side. Lift up the left leg, flex your left foot. Left leg stays parallel to the floor for now. Keep sucking the belly in, keep pushing the mat away with the hands. And into those 5 reps again, bend the left knee, keeping the left foot flexed, sole facing the ceiling. And as you exhale, lift the left leg up to the sky, inhale back down, exhale up, down, 2 more, up, down, and straighten the left leg, and come back to your tabletop. So hopefully you felt something a little bit on your glutes, warming up those glutes. Now, turning on the core, tuck the toes under, and you're going to lift the knees off the mat 1 or 2 inches. So staying in the shape of your tabletop, just floating the knees off the floor, shins stay parallel to the mat. Keep pushing the mat with the hands. Exhale, hips up and back into your downward facing dog. And feel free to bend one knee at a time, pedaling the feet. Maybe shaking the head out a few times as well. And feel free to do other movements in your down dog that feel great for today. Breathe in and out through the nose. And slowly find stillness in your down dog. Looking at the feet first, keeping them hip width distance. Toes pointing forward, heels pressing down. Legs are straight or maybe slightly bent. The knees if your hamstrings are tight or if your spine feels like it's rounded. Lift your hips up towards the sky. Lengthen the spine. Press your chest back towards your thighs. Keep pushing the mat away from you with your hands. One more breath in your down dog. Inhale, lift the right leg up into a three-legged box. Keep your hips squared to the mat. Now flex your right foot, toes pointing down. Then inhale, point your toes up to stand. And we'll do this 5 more times. Exhale, flex. Inhale, point. Exhale, flex. Inhale, point. That's 3 rounds. Inhale, flex. Point, last one, flex, point. Now flex your foot again, and right foot comes down. Other side, left leg comes up. Keep your hips squared down to the mat. Flex your left foot, goes pointing down in 5 reps again. Inhale, point, exhale, flex, inhale, point, exhale, flex, inhale, point. Exhale, flex, more, inhale, point. Exhale, flex, last one, inhale, point. Exhale, flex. And left foot comes back down to the floor, downward facing dog. Inhale, lift the right leg up again. And exhale, round the spine, shift the shoulders and top of the wrists, and bring the right knee close to your forehead. Point your toes back. Lift the right heel close to your bum. Inhale, look forward. Step the right foot forward between the hands. Lower the left knee down to the mat. Point your left toes back. Inhale, come up. Reach your arms up. Coming into your low lunge. Hips stay square to the front. Right knee on top of the right heel. Lower the shoulders roll back away from here. Feeling that nice stretch on your left hip flexor. If you want to intensify that stretch, bring the hips forward and down slightly. Keep lengthening the spine, tuck the tailbone in. So you're pointing the tailbone down to the floor, neutral spine. And imagine you're gathering energy and So doing 5 reps here. As you exhale, sweep your arms forward as if you're gathering energy in. And inhale up, keep your arms up. And exhale, sweep the arms forward, reach forward. Inhale, come back up. And exhale, sweep the hands forward. Inhale up, 2 more. Exhale, sweep it forward. Inhale up, last one. Exhale, sweep it forward. Inhale up. Exhale, hands to the floor. Drop the left toes under, left knee up. Step the right foot back to your plank. Your choice here, either straight into your downward facing dog or a vinyasa. If you're doing a vinyasa, option knees up or down. Shift forward, bend the elbows, chaturanga. Inhale into your back bone of choice, cobra or up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. And we'll do the opposite side. Inhale, look forward. Step the left foot forward, this side between the hands. Right knee down, point your right toes back. Inhale, come up, reach your arms up, low lunge. Hips stay square to the front. Tailbone still pointing down to the mat. Shoulders still relaxed away from the ears. And if you'd like a deeper stretch on your right hip flexor, move your hips forward and down. If your knees feel too much pressure, you can always add padding under the knee. Maybe rolling up your mat, adding a towel. And coming back to those 5 reps, exhale, reach forward as if you're gathering energy in, and inhale, come up. Exhale, reach forward. Inhale, up. And exhale, reach forward. Inhale up, 2 more. Exhale, reach forward. Inhale up, last one. Exhale, reach forward. Inhale up again. And exhale, hands down to the mat. Tuck your right toes under, right knee up. Step the left foot back in your plank. Once again, your choice. Either go straight up to your down dog. Or once again, slowly throw the vinyasa, knees up or down. Shift forward, bend the elbows, chaturanga. Inhale, lift the head and chest up to cobra. Or straighten the arms, lift the thighs off the floor, up dog. Exhale, turn the toes, hips up, downward facing dog. Taking 2 breaths here in your down dog. In and out. Draw the navel into the spine, keep the core active. Keep the arms strong, legs strong. Inhale, look forward. Step the right foot forward between the hands. Now this time, keep the left knee lifted, coming into your lowest lunge. Inhale, come all the way up, reach your arms up. So we're going to do a similar motion with arms here. Just almost the same, but different as well. So instead of forward and up, we're going to reach forward and back. So we're going to feel it open across the chest. Alright, now, so from your high lunge or crescent lunge, keep the right knee stacked on top of the right heel. Left leg either actively straight or you can keep a slight bend in the left knee. Now, as you exhale, reach forward. Inhale, sweep the arms back, open up the chest. Exhale, reach forward. Inhale, open up. Reach forward, again, open up. 2 more, reach forward. Open up. Last one, reach forward. And open up. And then come back to your crescent lunge, reach your arms up. Now hands on your hips. Step the left foot forward a few inches, straighten the right leg. So both legs straight, both feet flat on the floor, all 10 toes pointing forward. Inhale, lift the chest, lengthen the spine. And as you exhale, fold forward, halfway down. Inhale, come back up. And exhale, lower down halfway. Inhale, come up. One more time. And exhale, come down halfway. Inhale, come back up. Now this time, option one, fist bump behind you. Option two, hold on to opposite wrists, forearms, or elbows, whatever you can reach. Option three, into your reverse prayer hands. So I'll show you for a sec here. Fist bump, hold on to opposite wrists, forearms, or elbows, or prayer in reverse. So find your option. Inhale, look forward, lengthen the spine with the chest, and exhale, fold halfway down again. Keep the legs straight and strong, feet flat on the mat, keep the hips squared to the front as well, right hip back, left hip forward. Lengthen the crown of the head forward. And maybe stay in here halfway, or exhale, come all the way down. One more breath. And inhale, come all the way up. Now hands back to your hips. Adjust your right foot forward to widen out your stance. Bend the right knee slightly, shift your weight to your right leg. Then lift the left leg up slightly, a few inches. Imagine you're forming a straight line from the top of the head all the way to your left heel. Come up slightly, hinging from the hips, so your left foot is going back to the floor. Then exhale, lower down, however low you can go. Inhale, come back up. And exhale, lower down again. Inhale, come back up. Last one. Exhale, lower down again. Inhale, come back up. And let's go for a hold. Exhale, lower down. Warrior three. You can keep your hands on the hips or take another variation. Soften the right knee, land the left foot back down to the floor. And then open up into your warrior two. So you're facing the left side of your mat. Right knee bent on top of the right heel. Left leg straight with the left toes pointing to the long edge of your mat. Arms up parallel to the floor. Then we're going to come into what we call dancing warrior from your warrior two. Inhale, come into your reverse warrior, left hand to the left shin, right arm reaches up and back. And exhale, into your side angle, right elbow to the right knee, left arm overhead, bicep hinge to the left ear. Inhale, come back to your reverse warrior. And exhale, side angle. Three more times, inhale, reverse. And exhale, side angle. Inhale, reverse. And exhale, side angle. Last one. Inhale, reverse. And exhale, side angle. And come up to your warrior two. Straighten out the right leg, hands on the hips. Right toes in, and left toes out. And let's do the opposite side. Bend the left knee, arms up parallel to the floor, warrior two. So left knee on top of the left heel, left toes pointing to the short edge of your mat in the back, right toes pointing to the long edge of your mat. Arms parallel to the floor, and shoulder stack on top of the hips. Look to your left hand. Coming back to your dancing warrior, inhale. Right hand to the right shin, left arm comes up, reverse warrior. And exhale, left elbow to the left knee, right arm overhead, right angle. Inhale, reverse warrior. And exhale, side angle. Inhale, reverse. And exhale, side angle. Inhale, reverse. Exhale, side angle, last one. Inhale, reverse. And exhale, side angle. Inhale, come back to warrior two. And straighten out the left leg. Left toes in, hands on the hips. So all 10 toes now pointing to the long edge of your mat here. And We're going to come into a forward fold, feeling the stretch along the back of the legs. Inhale, land the spine with the chest, and exhale, fold forward with a straight spine. Come all the way down until you can release your hands to the floor. If you can't reach the floor today, you can use a prop like a thick book, a block, or anything else to elevate your hands up. So you're kind of using that as your floor instead. Keep the hands under the shoulders. Inhale, lengthen the spine forward, and exhale, come down deeper. Try to bring the top of the head to the floor. Lift the hips up to the sky. Keep the legs strong. Weight towards the ball of your feet. Maybe line up your fingertips with your toes. Shoulders away from the ears. One more breath here. And inhale. Walk the hands forward from up halfway. Now, hands on the hips, soften the knees, and slowly come up. And turn your toes out towards opposite sides. So your right toes at maybe 45 degree angle, and your left toes at the opposite 45 degree angle. I mean, that is a while since I did it. Okay, well, that kind of thing. All right, now, so your toes pointing outward in opposite directions, but not all the way out to the side, unless you really want to challenge yourself. Then from here, inhale, reach your arms up. And as you exhale, bend the knees, squat down low, then sweep your arms down, one palm and on top of the other. Inhale, come up, straighten your legs, reach your arms up. Exhale, bend the knees, sweep the arms down by the belly. Inhale, reach your arms up again, straighten your legs. And exhale, sweep the arms all the way down. Inhale, reach your arms up, straighten the legs. Exhale, bend the knees, sit down low. Arms down. Last one, inhale, reach your arms up. And exhale, come down. And let's fold. So hips down low, knees in top of the heels. Shoulders relax, away from the ears. Shoulders stack on top. So you're not leaning your body forward. You're staying upright. Last breath. And straighten the legs. Reach your arms up. And then hands on your hips. Turn the left toes in. Right toes out. And step the left foot next to the right. So you're standing at the top of your mat. In your Tadasana, release your arms right. So we're almost to the floor. Separate your feet wider than your hips, maybe about mat width distance. And we're going to come into an active squat as if you're doing up to that way. Okay, but I promise it's the last one, and then we hit the floor. So, toes are pointing outward. Then hands in prayer at the center of your chest. As you exhale, bend the knees, squat the hips, squat down. Keep the hips higher than the knees, slightly higher than the knees, or maybe as in line with the knees, but not lower. Lean the upper body back. Tailbone comes down. Inhale up. And exhale, come back down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale up. Two more. And exhale down. Inhale up, last one. Exhale down. Inhale up, and we're going to come all the way down into the garden squat. As you exhale, bend the knees with your hips all the way down. Elbows by your knees. Now stay clear to the center of your chest. Hips low, bring the upper body back. Press your elbows against the knees, and squeeze your knees, elbows to the knees. So they're opposing each other, your knees and your elbows. As your elbows want to open your knees wider, your knees press your elbows in. And release your hands down to the floor. Feel it. Hands come all the way down, sit on your mat, straighten your legs. Hands on the floor by your hips into your staff pose. Sit up tall, shoulders stacked on top of the hips, and keep that long spine. Suck the belly in for an active. Flex your feet, toes pointed up. Inhale, reach your arms up. And exhale, reach from the hips, lean forward. Reach your hands all the way forward, 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 forward. Inhale, come back up again. And exhale, hinge from the hips, lean forward. Chest reaches forward, fingers reach all the way forward, the spark forward again. And then release your hands down to the floor. Coming into your posture, Uttanasana. So options, either keep the hands on the floor or you can hold onto your feet, go ahead. Lengthen the spine, inhale, and exhale through. Taking care not to round the spine, keep the spine lengthened. Reach your chest forward and keep the chin away from your chest and through the toes. So you'll probably feel a stretch along the back of your neck. Relax the shoulders away from the ears. Shoulders back. And release the feet. Walk the hands back. Find your staff pose. Now bend your right knee, and place the sole of your right foot against your left inner thigh. Just adding a slight heart opener, back bend here, your knee well. Point your left toes forward, right hand close to the right hip. Inhale, lift the hips and chest up so you're flattening the left foot and right shin to the floor. Then reach your left hand forward. Look towards your left hand if you can. Lift the hips and chest up. Feel that stretch along the front of your body. And slowly release, come down. And let's add a twist. Lift the right knee up. Step the right foot outside the left thigh. Keep the left leg straight and active. Flex the left foot still. Hug the right knee with the left arm. Other hand onto the floor behind you. Lengthen the spine. Inhale. Suck the belly in. And exhale. Twist. Look past the right shoulder. One more breath. And slowly come back to center, straighten the right leg. Other side, bend the left knee, slowly the left foot against the right knee in front. Right leg active, right toes pointing up, foot flex. What do we call this? Left hand to the left hand to the floor by the left hip. Point your right toes. Inhale, lift the hips and chest up. Reach your right hand all the way forward. Forever back. Lift the hips and chest up as high as you can. Feel that stretch along the front. Flatten the right foot to the floor. And slowly come down. And lift up the left knee and step the left foot outside the right thigh. Keep the right leg active and flex that right foot. Hug the left knee with the right one. Left hand onto the mat behind you. Then lengthen as you inhale and twist as you exhale. Look past your left shoulder. Don't forget to breathe, even if it's not comfortable in this pose. Breathe, twist. Inhale, lengthen the spine, and exhale, twist deeper. Inhale, come back to center, and straighten up the left leg. And slowly lower down to lie on your back. And once you're on your back, point into your happy baby. Bend your knees. And bring your knees out to the sides towards your armpits. Hold onto your feet with the hands. And lift the feet up to the sky. Soles of the feet pointing up to the ceiling. Cradle your torso with your thighs. And you can stay here in stillness or feel free to also rock side to side if you want to. by installing in your happy baby. And you stay here for one more breath. And then hug your knees to your chest. And then Uttanasana. Legs together, hug your knees in, holding on to your knees with your hands. Or if you can, hold on to opposite elbows. And as you have to be able to make your Shavasana. Allow your feet to be as wide as the mat. Hands up to the sides, palms facing up. Eyes closed. Take a few breaths here and still there. Noticing the sensations of the body. Noticing where you feel any tension still. And see if you can soften. Let go. Just taking three more breaths here. And slowly start to wiggle the fingers and the toes. Move the wrists and ankles. Take the head side to side. And then give yourself a nice good stretch. Arms over head, back together, stretch. And then bend the knees, keep on the floor, and roll onto one side, using your arm as a pillow, other hand on the floor in front of your chest, and use that to help push yourself up into a comfortable seat. And thank yourself for being here today, for taking the practice.